When I was a teenager between ages 13 to 15, I developed a deep hatred for television because in the part of the world where I grew up, TV is 99% about entertainment. While entertainment itself isn't a bad thing, what I saw around me were people whose entire lives revolved around entertainment. As a young guy, I decided I would work hard on myself to make myself resourceful and productive. I borrowed and read every single book I could. I dreamt of becoming the best student in my school, and I achieved that. Then I dreamt of building a company, having a great marriage and living the exact way I want. I achieved all these dreams and not because I had better opportunities than most people, but because I focused on taking care of my days. You see, Jordan Peterson said, and I quote, "If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. If you pay attention to the 24 hours you have now and do that each day, you won't need to worry about the next 24 years. If you take care of today and each day, your future will take care of itself." The problem with most young people is that they focus too much on the future. These people think about a future when they would have all the money, but they avoid the daily discipline that leads to such a future. These people wish they could become successful artists, athletes, writers, entrepreneurs, or anything like that, but they wouldn't make daily sacrifices that lead to such a future. Stop deceiving yourself. Tomorrow doesn't exist. It will never come. Today is the only day you'll ever see. So if you don't take care of today, you can't have a meaningful future. If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. Michael Joseph Jackson was born on August 29, 1958. When he was only 5, Michael Jackson started his music career and went on to become one of the most successful musicians ever in the history of our planet. But wait a second. Michael Jackson didn't become a successful musician because he wanted to be. More than a decade ago, I read a newspaper story about how Michael Jackson practices dance and music for 8 long hours every day. I later watched a video of him where he confessed that he would always stay awake at night, practicing his music again and again. Some of Jackson's assistants confessed that he would practice each of his steps 100 times and would still not be satisfied. In 1979, Michael Jackson broke his nose during one of his rigorous practice, and after his death on June 25, 2009, Michael Jackson's autopsy report revealed that his feet were seriously deformed, possibly from the excessive dance stunts, which was the reason why he always wore socks. Now, you can see, Michael Jackson didn't become a great musician because he wished, wanted, or waited to be. It was his daily commitment and sacrifices that made Jackson the king of pop. Now, let me ask you this question. What do you want to do with your life? It doesn't matter what that is. The only thing that matters is your daily commitment towards that goal. If you can pursue it every day, you can have it. If you can't make sacrifices for it day after day, you'll never get it. If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. Born February 5, 1985, Cristiano Ronaldo started his life pretty roughly. In fact, his mother attempted to have an abortion when she was carrying him, simply because the family was too poor to care for another child. But the abortion wouldn't be allowed by the doctor. As a young child, Ronaldo fell in love with football. He would spend hours and hours practicing instead of reading for school, and later got expelled from school at age 14. 1 year later, at age 15, Ronaldo was diagnosed with a racing heart, a condition that could have forced him to give up playing football. Ronaldo underwent heart surgery where a laser was used to cauterize multiple cardiac pathways into one, altering his racing heart rate. He was discharged from the hospital hours after the procedure and resumed training a few days later. Aside from his heart challenge, Ronaldo was belittled by different people for being fragile, and this, his critics claimed, would stop him from being a successful footballer. But young Ronaldo wouldn't listen. Day after day, he would spend hours and hours working out and practicing his skill. Up till today, Cristiano Ronaldo still sacrifices 6 difficult hours every day to become a better football player, even though he had become one of the most successful footballers in the world. If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. There's only one single day in your lifetime, and it's called today. No other day matters because you'll never live in them. You can't live in yesterday, and you can't live in tomorrow. Your life's obligations is to take good care of today, because that's the only day you'll ever have. It doesn't matter what goal you have for the next decade or even the next year. If you wake up each day and expect your life to be better one day, it will never be better. People who achieve greatness in life are those who take care of every day of their lives. Whether you talk about business, music, politics, or even science, the successful people in any field are those who take responsibility and make a daily sacrifice for their long-term goal. If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. My journey to becoming a writer. About 20 years ago, I was still in secondary school in a small town in Nigeria. I would leave my parents' home on weekends and go to a lonely place to write. If you ask me today, I don't know what I was writing. The only thing I know is I loved to join words together. But listen to this. That you love to do something doesn't mean that you'll ever become successful doing it. To become successful in any field, years and years of daily practice and sacrifice is needed. Pay attention to these words. Daily, every day. In my own case, I have spent the last 7 years consciously writing as many days as possible, as at the time of making this video, I write about 6,000 words every week. That's an average of 900 words per day. These days, I receive messages from people who tell me how good my writings are. Well, my writings aren't good by accident. They are good because I practice making them good daily. If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. New Year resolution is nonsense. Usually, towards the end of each year, people's emotions get to their way of thinking. Since everyone wants to achieve something bigger, people figure out that the best time to pursue such a goal is at the beginning of a new year. Hence, they set new goals for the year and make new resolutions. But New Year resolution is a waste of time. According to the US News and World Report, 80% of New Year's resolutions fail by February. A 2007 study by Richard Wiseman from the University of Bristol involving 3,000 people showed that 88% of those who set New Year resolutions fail, despite the fact that 52% of the study's participants were confident of success at the beginning of the year. The University of Scranton's research suggests that just 8% of people achieve their New Year's goals, which means 92% of resolutions fail. But why do most people forget their New Year's resolution by the second month of the year? Well, you can't ever live in the future. You can't take care of the future. You can't even plan for the future. The best and only important goal you can set for yourself is to take care of today. I mean today. You can't take care of next year, not even next month. By focusing on a year, you give yourself the ticket to waste as much possible days as possible, since your focus is on the year. By taking care of today, by seeing today as the only day you'll ever have, you put yourself in a position where you get the best out of each day. If you fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future. Here's what you should do. Sit down and make a list of three important things you'd like to achieve in the next 10 years. Then determine what you must sacrifice each day of your life for those things to be achieved. This can be practiced. It can be reading and studying. It can be a brainstorming session with someone. It can be taking actions and making mistakes. The point is, you have to do something every day that takes you a step closer to your goal, or you'll never achieve such a goal. If you'll fulfill your obligations every day, you don't need to worry about the future.